Shalom, and welcome to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul, your Biblical Hebrew podcast. Shalom, and welcome to our Biblical Hebrew podcast. Yehoshua-Bin-Nun, the student of Moses, cursed the person who will build the city of Jericho. In Joshua chapter 6, we find the curse. Curse is the man who shall build Jericho. He will lose his first son while building the foundation to it, and he shall lose his last son while putting its doors up, meaning the end of the process of building. 400 years later, in Kings 1:16, we find an interesting verse that describes the following. 400 years later, Achab is the king of Israel. And the Bible says that in the days or the times of Achab, a person named Chiel-Bet-Ha-Eli built the city of Jericho, and while he put the foundation to the city, he lost his first son, Aviram, and while he put the doors to the city, he lost his youngest son, Zguv. And the Bible says that this process happened due to the words of Yehoshua bin Nun, because Yehoshua bin Nun cursed the person who shall build the city of Jericho. And 400 years later, those words stood and kept alive. And this is what happened to the person who built the city of Jericho against Yehoshua's words. An interesting teaching of the Talmud tells us the two people came to comfort Chiel after losing his sons. Those two people were Achab, the king of Israel, and Eliyahu, the prophet. Achab was pushing Eliyahu in the following words, at this moment of comforting Chiel after losing his children. And so says Achab, poking Eliyahu, "Can it be that the words of the student are bigger than the words of a teacher?" Meaning, can it be that the words of the student Yehoshua are being actualized? Because Yehoshua cursed the person who shall build Jericho, and so it happened 400 years later. And can it be that the words of Yehoshua are bigger than the words of Moses? Because Moses warned the sons of Israel in the fifth book of Moses, chapter 11, "Be careful, be cautious, that your heart shall not follow other ways. Because if you shall do so, if you shall move your heart from the right way, God will stop the water from the heavens, and you shall have no water." So Achab was using those words of Moses to poke Eliyahu, saying, "Can it be that the words of Yehoshua are happening and the words of Moses are not happening? The teacher, the great teacher Moses, the master of prophets. Look, everybody's here following foreign worship. Everybody is not going the right way. And still, there is rain falling from the sky." Meaning, what kind of a teacher is Moses? His words are never happening. And Yehoshua is bigger than his teacher, because the words of Yehoshua happened, and we are here comforting this man who lost his children, and the words of a great teacher, the master of prophets, are not happening. He was laughing at Eliyahu. And immediately Eliyahu answers in verse 1, chapter 17. And so he says, Chai Hashem, live the name Elohei Israel, gods of Israel, Asher amadeti lefanav, that I stood in front of him. Im yihyeh hashanim ha'ele, if in those years shall be tal umatar, dew and rain, ki im lefi dvari, but according to my words. And here we see in a way how Eliyahu proceeds the words of the great teacher Moses, saying to Achav, the words of the teacher are happening. You want to see why? You want to see that the words of the teacher are actual reality? Here. This is how Eliyahu punches back. You thought that the student is bigger or greater than the teacher? Well, you're wrong. The words of the teacher are always valid. And here is the proof. Now let's look into Eliyahu's words and see what kind of secret hides in the words of his speech. Eliyahu says, Chai Hashem. The name is alive. Let's look into those two words. Chai, alive, is written in two letters, Chet and Yod. Chet equals 8, Yod equals 10. Together they make 18. Hashem, the tetragrammaton, is written in four letters. Yod, He, Vav, He. Yod is 10, He is 5, so together there are 15, plus Vav, which is 6, there are 21, plus another He, which is 5, there are 26. Now the word Hashem, the tetragrammaton, we can write in feeling how it is being pronounced. When we feel the four letters of the name in the letter Yod, we get the following. The first letter Yod, we write Yod Vav Dalet, which equals 20. The second letter He, we write with its filling He Yod, which is 15. And we connect it to the 20, which is the first Yod, we have 35. And then the letter Vav with the filling of Yod, we write Vav Yod Vav, which is 22. And 22 with 35 is 57. And He with the filling of Yod is He Yod, which is 50. And 57 plus 15 is 72. So the name of God, Hashem, with the filling of the letter Yod in it, gives us the volume of 72. Now, if we add to the sum of 72 Chai, the sum of 18, we get the number 90. 90 is the volume of the word water, Maim. For Mem is 40, Yod is 10, and another Mem is 40. Together it's 90. And you see, in a way, by not using the word water, because Eliyahu does not use the word water, Maim, in the Hebrew sentence. He says, Chai Hashem, live the name. But if we abstract the letters of the words Chai Hashem, we see water inside. Because in the rest of the sentence, Eliyahu says, Tal, dew, umatar, and rain. Eliyahu does not mention the word water at all, but in its coded way, Chai Hashem. Now the question, what does it mean? Because the word water which is hidden or implied in the code Chayashem, the word water in Hebrew, we can also write in its filling. How? The letter Mem, we write Mem and another Mem. The letter Yod in its filling is written Yod Vav Dalet. And the letter Mem Sofit is also written Mem and another Mem. And we have the following. The first Mem equals Mem, and Mem is 40 plus 40. This is 80. Yod equals 20. And Mem and other Mem, 40 plus 40 is 80. So the filling of the word water is 180, which is 10 times high. So you see, by the words of Eliyahu, if we decode his terms, we find the hidden structure of the word water. And in the water, we see code of 10 times alive. And this is Eliyahu's words. And in a way, Eliyahu is the successor of Moses. And we see, according to his speech, how Moses' words are getting their actualization. We wish you a beautiful day and wonderful week. Thank you for listening to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul. We hope that you enjoyed this episode. If you have any questions, comments, or would like to hear more about a certain topic, just write us an email to hebrew@learnoutlive.com. We are always happy to hear from you. For more episodes, videos, and articles like this, please visit our website at hebrew.learnoutlive.com. We also would like to invite you to join our live classes. Just search for Online College of Biblical Hebrew on Facebook and start learning now with students from all over the world. Kol Tov and Shalom.